You are comparing two cell phone plans. Company A offers a monthly fee of $35 plus $10 per gigabyte of data. Company B offers a monthly fee of $70 plus $5 per gigabyte of data. Number one, write linear equations that model these cell phone plans. Before we do this, we need to define variables to represent the unknowns. And we have two unknowns. We don't know the monthly cost or the number of gigabytes used per month. Let's let C equal the monthly cost and X equal the number of gigabytes of data used per month. Now that we've defined the variables, we can write the linear equations that model the two cell phone plans. For company A, the monthly cost C is equal to $35 plus $10 per gigabyte of data, and therefore we have C equals 35 plus 10x. For company B, the monthly cost C is equal to $70 plus $5 per gigabyte of data, and therefore we have C equals 70 plus 5x. For number two, if 4 gigabytes of data is used each month, which company is cheaper and by how much? If 4 gigabytes of data is used, we know x equals 4. To answer this question, we substitute 4 for x in both cost equations. For company A, the monthly cost C is equal to 35 plus 10 times 4, which equals 35 plus 40, which equals 75, and of course the units are dollars. So if 4 gigabytes of data is used per month, company A will charge $75 per month. And now for company B, the monthly cost C is equal to 70 plus 5 times 4, which is 70 plus 20, which equals $90. So if 4 gigabytes of data is used each month, company B will charge $90 per month. So we know company A is cheaper. To determine how much cheaper, we found the difference of these two amounts. 90 minus 75 is equal to 15, and therefore company A is cheaper by $15 per month. For number three, if 12 gigabytes of data is used each month, which company is cheaper and by how much? Same type of question, but now we're given x equals 12. So for company A, the monthly cost C is equal to 35 plus 10 times 12, which equals 35 plus 120, which equals $155 per month as a monthly cost. Company B, the monthly cost C is equal to 70 plus 5 times 12, which equals 70 plus 5 times 12 is 60. 70 plus 60 equals 130. Again, the units are dollars. So if 12 gigabytes of data is used each month, notice now company B is cheaper by $25 per month. We know it's $25 because 155 minus 130 does equal 25. So company B is cheaper by $25 per month. And now for the last question, how many gigabytes per month would yield equal monthly statements from both companies? What would the monthly cost be? Let's answer this question on the next slide. To determine how many gigabytes per month would yield equal monthly payments, we want to determine when the cost will be the same, and this occurs when 35 plus 10x is equal to 70 plus 5x. 35 plus 10x equals the monthly cost for company A, and 70 plus 5x equals the monthly cost for company B. If we solve this equation for x, we can determine how many gigabytes per month would yield equal monthly statements. To solve for x, we need to have the x terms on one side of the equation. Let's subtract 5x on both sides. Simplifying, we have 35, 10x minus 5x is 5x, so we have plus 5x equals 70, and 5x minus 5x is equal to 0. And now we isolate the x term on one side of the equation by subtracting 35 on both sides. Simplifying, 35 minus 35 is 0, giving us 5x equals 70 minus 35 is equal to 35. Last step, to solve for x, we divide both sides by 5. Simplifying, 5 divided by 5 simplifies to 1. 1 times x is x. X equals 35 divided by 5, which equals 7. So now we can answer the first question. The monthly cost is the same for both companies if 7 gigabytes of data is used per month. And now to answer the question, what would the monthly cost be? We substitute 7 for x into either equation, because remember, this is when the cost for both companies will be the same. Let's just go ahead and use this first equation here. So the monthly cost C is equal to 35 plus 10 times 7, which equals 35 plus 70, which equals $105 per month. Let's just verify that we also get 105 when we substitute 7 into the second equation. We would have C equals 70 plus 5 times 7, which equals 70 plus 35, which does equal 105. So now we know the cost would be $105 per month. Before we go, let's also look at this graphically. If you were to graph these two equations on the coordinate plane, where we have the number of gigabytes per month on the horizontal axis and the cost per month in dollars along the vertical axis, notice how these two lines intersect at this point here. The coordinates of this point are 7, 105. Where 7 represents the number of gigabytes, where the two plans have the same cost, and the 105 represents the monthly cost for both plans. I hope you found this helpful.